Empaths, it's Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning subs, my grown, extended, beautiful family, just thank you so much for the love and support that you have shown me each and every day. Our channel is growing so much. It's like here to support all empaths to know that they are truly not alone. They're not suffering alone. We're all here for each other, and you know that's very beautiful because we need so much love in the world right now through all the crazy stuff we're going through. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light, and many blessings are definitely coming your way. If you've been watching my videos for a while and have not already, please like and subscribe. Even hit that notification bell at the bottom so you know when your girl's about to upload her next video. Also, if you feel like the video, if you're comfortable, please go ahead and drop me a line on my video. You know, I love to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me, even if it's about the positive feedback of the content of my video. Or, you know, you just tell me about your empath, the gift, and how it impacted your life and heading you towards a positive direction. Also, if you feel like the videos just gave you good vibes or good info that you would love to share with a fellow empath or somebody who truly needs to hear it right now, please go ahead and do so. And while you're at it, give me a thumbs up, like, and even share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. And thank you so much for stopping by my channel and showing so much love and support. It is so greatly appreciated. And I hope you're able to, you know, resonate with the content of my video. Y'all, I told y'all I'm doing this on every video. I told my daughter I would help her do this. And I know y'all probably tired of hearing me say it, but you know, if you're a parent, you truly understand when you do things for your kids, you go all the way. So, you know, my daughter's getting ready. She's trying to publish her book, and she's trying to see if she can get donations, and you know, whatever is greatly appreciated, even if it's a couple of dollars. If you can, I will be posting her website in my description box below. So if you're able to help out or just give a couple of dollars towards a donation, I'll greatly appreciate it. You know, it's about her drawings and poet, you know, putting poems together. It's just a whole bunch of different people collaborated so they can put it in a book, and it's very beautiful. And she's been working so hard for that. You know, just got me a text from her now, and she's like crying tears of joy because there's so many people that have been donating. It's truly a blessing. I told her she was so scared that she wasn't going to get anything, you know, by that, you know, by her due date. You have to trust and believe and have faith. You know, I kept telling her that. So beautiful things is heading towards her way. So, the beautiful meditation music I'm listening to right now is Prayer for Healing. 3 hours of blissful meditation music, inner body awareness, and positive energy. And I'll post that link in the description box below. Y'all, it's like I love listening to this meditation music because it just gives me good vibes. You know, even though we might go through so much hell and high water, we have to appreciate the beautiful things that's, you know, that's coming towards our way. You know, you have to be able to be grateful for the bad times as well as the good times, you know, because we learn through our hard times. We get our strength from our pain and all that. But today my video is about Twin Flame 101, feel the worth within your words. I always tell people that, feel the worth within your words, because you have to have confidence in yourself. You know, I know there's a lot of us who have been through very abusive childhood trauma, where you felt like you weren't worthy, you weren't good enough. You've been probably told that. You know, I've heard that a lot of times. Why couldn't you be like this person? You always get, you know, people, sometimes when people, you know, have been taught that, they push it on towards their children, which is sad. You have to understand that, you know, some people are just like that. If they hate themselves, they can't love anybody. And I always try to tell people that, you know, when people are mean towards you, it's because they're reflecting what they feel about themselves towards you. You have to feel your worth within your words. You know, if you know you are worthy, you don't need the next person to tell you that. You never need somebody to validate who you are. You know, I try to tell people that. And I went through that. You know, my stepsister and my stepbrother are very successful. Me, I'm a high school dropout and had children starting at 16. So, you know, it was like they kept spewing out on me. I wasn't good enough. You know, you'll be this, you'll be that, because they knew who my father was. So, you know, they tried to push that bad on me, tried to talk bad about me to my father. You know, even when my dad talked to me, he was like, oh, you're nothing that they, you know, you're nothing like what they say you are. And I knew he was trying to basically tell me they talk bad about me to him, but that never made him stop loving me, and that's what they wanted. So, you know, I feel the worth within my words. You know, I have to be confident for what I say. You know, you have to be confident for what you say. Because if you're out there pushing out positivity, you have to believe within your words. You have to believe in yourself to know what I'm saying is true. You know, what I'm doing is true. I'm in my true self suit. I'm walking my true path. You know, even though it might be hard as hell to do it, you're still doing that. You know, you're not giving up on yourself. You're not giving up on your dreams. You're not giving up on the things that you're trying to achieve. You know, I always tell my kids that, you know, be worthy of yourself. If nobody else, be worthy of yourself. You know, we have to be, you know, when you're putting stuff out like that, you have to know your worth. You know that I'm not going to stand here and let somebody walk over me. I'm not going to stand here and let somebody disrespect me. If they can't see my worth, I know I can see my worth. You hurt yourself more when you stay in a position you're not supposed to be in. That's the reason why we go through so much hell. You're like, Roslynn, you know, this, my friend, you know, stopped talking to me. Or, you know, I broke up, you know, me and my boyfriend broke up. These things, you're having to see people for who they truly are. When you're heading towards something big and beautiful, God will expose, God and universe exposes people to you. And it can be the worst type of way, like, God, dog, I'm coming through a come up and this happens to me now. You know, I've gone through all this, you know, for the last 2 years. People I know for like a long time, it could be between 6 and 20 years. Then all of a sudden they find out who I'm really related to or who I really am. And they're mad, like, Roslynn, why didn't you tell me this? Why would I? You know, you probably wouldn't believe me anyway. You know, so it's just like, or I didn't want people to act funny or treat me different because of who I was related to. And, you know, it hurt because it was just people I would, like, fight for war for that wouldn't even basically cross a little puddle for me, you know? So, I mean, yes, that was hurtful. But then when I look at it, there's not everybody supposed to be. When you start your journey, there's going to be a handful of people with you. By the time you finish that journey, you'll be lucky if you have, out of that handful of people, you brought five with you. You probably, you know, but it's just like you have to go through these things. You have to get away from people that don't want good for you. You know, and I always tell people, I feel like we all can go through the finish line together. But, you know, some people try to compete against you. I have family members competing against me. I'm like, we're family. Why should you even do that? You're you. I'm me. You know, we're all on different levels. We're all up on different journeys. So I can't compare myself to you. You can't compare yourself to me. I don't look down on nobody. You know, I feel like, you know, I don't laugh at situations that people go through because, like, I've always thought, and no. Don't laugh at people's hardship because God can honestly put you in that same situation for you to see what they had to go through. Or, you know, people try to pray and wish it was like, oh, I wish I was her. I wish I was, you know, I was related to such and such and such. Until you had to see what I actually had to go through just because I was related to such and such and such. Everybody want to be in your position until they find out what you had to do to be in that position. Then you're like, whoa, hold up. You know, you can't do that. It's just like, you know, when people find out all the things I went through, they're like, Roslynn, you are very strong. I mean, I wasn't like this. I wasn't built up by Maytag. You know that. Remember the commercial, Maytag is built up strength. You know, I had to go through that to know my worth, know the words within my worth. You know, knowing there's people in the same situation as me questioning themselves. Why am I got to go through this? I love people. I push out positivity. But people hurt me. They see the strength inside of you that they don't see inside themselves. That's why, you know, they struggle to love themselves every day. Some people just don't even like themselves, you know? So they can't sit up here and love you when they don't love themselves. And I tell a lot of people that, you know, when you go through things and all of a sudden this person gets popped out your life or this person ignores you, God's letting you know these people aren't supposed to be in your life anyway because they're not any good for you. So when you're going through things, know your worth. Knowing that you are better than what people try to post you out to be. Some people try to expose things that's supposed to be bad about you because they can't accept the right things about you. But just keep doing you. You know that pretty soon you won't, like I always say, it's just like, you know, I try not to talk about my family too much because it's just like, I'm not going to keep talking about them because usually you don't got to expose fake people. They'll end up messing up and exposing themselves. So that's the reason why you might hear it pop up in a conversation every once in a while. But it's just like, this is what my chance is now. to help other empaths like me to understand this is the reason why we're going through these things. You're a strong person. You just have to be able to see it within yourself. There are sometimes I question my worth at times, and then I get put in a position where you're like, hold up, wait a minute. You know, because it's just like I tell people, you know, I'm not trying to be rude or whatever. Just like I tell people, if I'm on one-on-one with you and I don't mind you sending me messages, but it has to be through a certain period of time. I said, I don't want to get any messages from you past 11 p.m. Before 8 o'clock in the morning. Don't send nothing like that unless it's an absolute emergency. If it is like a life and death emergency, go ahead, text away. Because you never know what somebody's going through at that time, you know. Because there's times where I don't felt like I didn't want to live anymore. I just want that pain to go away. There's times that we feel that way where we don't want to live anymore just because you have to deal with pain. I've seen too many empaths out here, especially celebrities. They've went through so much mess. Next thing you know, they done committed suicide because they couldn't deal with it anymore. I don't need anybody I know that can do that when they can easily talk to somebody. Find somebody you can trust. Find somebody that won't look at you a certain way because you feel a certain way. Because nobody is perfect. We all go through certain situations, but we have to go through it to get to it. You got to remember that. So I hope you're able to resonate with the content of this video, knowing, you know, just be gentle with yourselves. Be patient. You know, we all got to go through things to get through it, and that going through those things make you really strong. So knowing it always has a positive purpose at the end. So I hope you're able to resonate with the content of my video. Like and subscribe, give me a thumbs up, share, and drop me a line. I love a chance to hear from you. And know that you are truly blessed, highly favored, and forever loved, and knowing there's always a way out there praying for your better days. So my post notification shout out goes to Mang Jaho. Now I think it's Manjo, Nadar. I'm at 77, and Lofea Vonoden. I hope I didn't mess your name up. I apologize if I didn't, but I did try. Give me an A for effort. But give me a post notification so I can go ahead and give you a shout out on my next video. Send out as much love and positivity as you possibly can, and I will see you on my next video. Peace and be wild.